Episode 2046, is your identity tied in your thoughts?
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive. Happy every day, rise and shine. It is time to get into the game of life. Are you ready to be encouraged? Are you ready to look forward to something new and different in your life? It's Mindset Monday. Is your identity tied in your thoughts? For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, mindset is so key to how we conduct ourselves in our everyday. What we think about, we bring about. Thoughts can play tricks on you. You may see one thing, but think something else. Is your identity tied in your thoughts? Your thoughts are the heartbeat of your actions. Again, what you think about, you bring about. So what are you thinking about? Did you get up this morning and you said, yep, I'm looking mighty fine. I am so raring to go in this world. I've got it all put together. I'm building my confidence. I'm going to go out and strike gold today. Okay, maybe not in those exact words, but something to the extent of, you know what, I got this. I'm really confident in where I'm going and there's no problem. Most of us do not wake up like that. We wake up grumpy and grouchy. We're like, oh, seriously, would you look at that mess? Hot mess. I need to go get my hair done. I need to get my nails done. I need to get a haircut. There's something about, I need to lose weight. Oh my gosh, I'm not ready for this project. What was I thinking when I said yes, school's starting. I have so much to do in the house. I thought I would be ready for the company and I'm not. That's real life right there. That's the snapshot of every day. When we get up and we begin to throw questions as to who we are. Your actions are supported by your thoughts. So as you think about who you are, you capture what sticks with you. You're like, okay, yeah, maybe I don't get it. So maybe I'm really not that confident. And so where does that, you know, self-esteem play out? Oh, well, I guess my self-esteem is kind of there, but maybe it's not. And well, this is just how it is. And I'm going to go with the flow. If you have that attitude to just go with the flow all the time, that you're just like, okay, it's not this flexibility attitude, not that. That's a whole nother episode. But this attitude, like, I don't really control anything. Life happens to me. I'm just going to react. I'm just going to respond. And that's how it's going to be. I don't have much of a choice, but you do. Because when you begin to think about who you are, right, you are taking hold of what sticks with you. You have tens of thousands of thoughts that run through your mind every day. Some of them you're like, oh yeah, I got that one. And others you're like, what was I thinking? And some of it is even a dialogue inside your head. And at times you're probably going, if anybody could see in my head, it would be very, very scary. I know I've had those and that's okay. It's normal. You're not abnormal. You don't need to go to the doctor to see whether or not something's going wrong. No, it's called life. And when you care enough to begin to really look at what you're thinking, like think about your thoughts. Think about that statement. Okay, we've got a lot of thinking of thoughts, of thinking of thoughts, of thoughts that we're thinking. All in all, when you look at your identity becomes defined by your thoughts. If you were to wake up every single morning and believed that you were the princess and you were beautiful and courageous and gorgeous, do you think your life would be a little bit different? Yeah. But when you don't believe that you're the princess and you believe that you've been dealt some cards in life that are unfair, that you've got kids that are just disobedient right now. It's like they're going through their terrible twos, but they're like 10, 15 years older than terrible twos. You're like, how am I going to get through these tween and teenage years? Maybe you're looking at yourself going, I'm just not feeling it. I'm not feeling good about who I am. Maybe you've had a rough time in your marriage. And even through all of that, you're sitting here going, gosh, I was told over and over again that I'm a pile of trash, that I'll never add up to anything. And what do you think you begin to believe? That, yeah, I'm a pile of trash. Now, that may be said to you over and over again, but if that's the thought that you grab onto, where do you think you're going to stay? Right there. And you begin to wrap your identity up because your identity is defined by your thoughts. Now, for those of you who are saying, now, Christiane here, let's be serious. What about the religious aspect? Religion plays an important part. You know, in my opinion, God created you on purpose for a purpose, and He has given you an identity. However, a lot of us do not see our identity through Him. We see it through our own fragile, earthly eyes, sinful eyes that gravitates toward negativity, that gravitates toward what we can't do, not what we were created to do. We need to begin to put on different lenses. So in our time together right now, I really wanted to take that out for just a moment. And I want you to really just pause and think seriously, how do you believe who you want to be? How would you answer that question? How do you believe who you want to be? Did it come from, oh, just one morning you woke up and said, this is who I am? Or has it been a period of time? And in different situations and circumstances, you have nitpicked different thoughts, sentences, and you have taken them as your own, whether they are thoughts that you thought all by yourself or thoughts that were placed upon you and you rethought them. You continued to regurgitate them over and over again, and you're like, okay, yeah, I'm kind of that. Why do you think that out of the blue, when someone else gives a compliment to you, that you're like, oh my gosh, I didn't see that in me, but now it feels so good to hear it. It feels good to hear it. Number one, if it's truth, awesome. Grab it. Hold on to it. But number two, it's because you chose at whatever time to not hear that, even if it was said to you. You ignored that thought and you took on another one. So how do you believe who you want to be? Well, you got to choose which thought you hold. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Choose which thought you hold. I can remember growing up, middle school, and definitely 100% high school. I mean, literally, I can picture myself in my bed in Hawaii. I had a twin little bed, white bed. I know this is going to be kind of crazy. And it had little post for where you could put a canopy on it. I know that's probably really old. I'm so sorry. And you're going to be thinking other thoughts of me. But yes, I was a girly girl growing up and I enjoyed my canopy. And I loved decorating and rearranging and doing things fresh and new. But I also loved diving deeper and thinking things through. Not just, oh, okay, well, here's my day. I'm going about my day. No. I would lay down at night underneath my little canopy after I'd stayed up way too long doing homework because I stayed in the band room like forever doing other things. And so I would get home and I would have tests. And so I would see late night into wee morning hours. And I can remember laying there going, gosh darn it, I remember the situation. And I would replay the conversation I had with someone. I would replay the thoughts. I would replay a comment another student said to me. Or even I would replay just looks that were given to me. And I would analyze, gosh, is that really me? Or wow, if it was, did I respond appropriately? Or maybe I reacted instead of responding. Choose which thought you hold. You have a choice in life every single moment. Every moment. And if you were to think about every single moment, number one, by the end of the actual day, you're going to be exhausted, which is incredible how God has created the human body and the way the brain works. And we could be here forever just on the science aspect of that. But for now, I want us to keep it somewhat simple. If you were to think about everything, like, okay, I got to take a breath here. And now what I'm going to think about is this. And oh, wait, now I'm going to go to the bathroom too. But in going to the bathroom, I still have to breathe. And then after I do that, I'm going to move a little to the left because it's just a little uncomfortable here on the right. And I want to feel good. Oh, wait, I got to take a breath again. Okay, seriously, when we sit here and dissect every single thought, okay, we can't do it. And that's why the way our body works and our mind works, it's absolutely astounding. And I am always in awe when I begin to look at how God created us. And so when it comes to identity, we truly have the choice every single day as to what we do, what we think about, and then what we bring about. Choose which thought you hold. Laying under that canopy, looking up, pretending there were stars above me, exhausted, but excited at the same time, mixed emotions all over the world. Why? Because I was a high schooler. And I would lay there and say, gosh, did she really say that to me? Now I can act the way maybe she thought I was, but did I? I don't want to be that type of a person, so I want to really look at it this way. And so I would make a choice as to which thought I would hold. But you see, rewind elementary into middle school. Kids say the craziest darn things, don't they? And at times, when you're the adult, you want to laugh about it, but as a child receiving that, not so much. It stings. Words hurt. And those words are thoughts that come out of somebody else's mouth. And for us, if we're thinking those own thoughts, it's words that are held within our mind that we release as sentences. And it goes to the heart. And some of them are really great and others are really, really bad. And they do some major damage. And I can remember being a younger girl, not in high school, much younger. And I can remember replaying a few circumstances like, I don't remember ever acting that way. Why would she call me that? Am I really like that? And I would then begin to question who I was. Just because some person, some child, some other student sat here and threw words at me like daggers, of which then pierced my mind, which then what? I took in and said, is this really who I am? Choose which thought you hold. What are you feeding your mind? Is it junk? Or is it greatness? What is it? You have to be so careful as to what you are putting in your mind. So what are you consuming? What are you reading? What are you watching? What are you listening to? Yeah, even me. There are times that I will replay something in my mind that I said to my child, and I'm like, oh, if I could just have it back. Just one time. And then there are things my children will bring up, and they'll be like, Mom, you really said that. And I'm like, well, I didn't mean it that way, but you see, they took it another way. And if you look at the whole circumstance of the conversation and how it was all intertwined together, it made complete sense. But if you were to pull out only 4 or 5 words and you replay that sentence over and over in the mind, it becomes this thought that actually can be devastating to your child. What are you feeding your mind? Is it junk? Is it greatness? And then how are you acting on that thought? Some of your thoughts, you've got to let go. You've got to bury them. You've got to get rid of them. You have to get them out of your mind. And that means what? Replacing them with truth. You created on purpose for a purpose. You can make a difference every single day. You can impact the world that you touch. Will you make mistakes? Ha, yes. So celebrate those. Lesson learned. But that doesn't mean that you have to wake up every morning and look at yourself in the mirror and say, you're no good. Why are you doing what you're doing? You want to start a business? Are you serious? What are you, stupid? I know these thoughts that go on in your head. And they're wrong. And if you keep telling yourself over and over and over again, you're going to have nothing to believe but that of which you're telling yourself. Choose which thought you hold. Align yourself to the thought you want to become. I love that. Because you may not be who you want to be right now, but you know that God has created you for more. You're trying to see yourself through His eyes, not yours. And so you begin this journey. How can I become more like Him? How can I make choices that elevates who I am to become? I may not be there. I may never get there. Remember, it's not about the destination. It is the journey, the lessons learned. And then guess what? The lessons you get to share. Choose which thought you hold. So I got a question for you. I want you to go back to when you first woke up this morning, when you actually could remember a thought that you had. Sometimes we wake up in the morning and it's like, oh my gosh, I'm so groggy. I don't know what happened in the morning. We are starting school today. I have 3 children out of our 5 that are back in school as of today. 2 in college and 1 in high school. And some are starting only virtual, and our high schooler is actually doing a hybrid model. And so it's a hopping time right now for us, and it's new adventures. And I can remember when I was a child during that time in my life on a new adventure. And I was nervous. And I was like, I don't know anybody. See, I was in Hawaii growing up in high school. And I moved back to the mainland to go to college. Nobody knew me. I was a stranger. And I went to a very, very small school. And there were a lot of friends that came and went to school together to that small private school. And then you had me. I know what it's like to sit there and question who you are. We all do it. That's a healthy thing. Question who you are, where you're going. But be careful of your answer. Choose which thought you hold and align yourself to the thought you want to become. Go out today, be present, be incredible, be you. I believe in you. I'm carrying that belief torch. Come on, God's got great blessings in store for you. So go out and look for them today. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.